the recycling of ships generates some waste, some of which is hazardous or toxic, and this needs to be taken care of in an environmentally sound manner. There is an international convention that regulates the movement of waste and hazardous waste from one country to the other. This is the well-known Basel Convention. However, the Basel Convention does not contain shipping governance structures, and the result of that is that it's not enforceable on ships. The second problem is that the Basel Convention is a generic instrument and does not address any specific requirements on ships or on shipping, or on ship recycling facilities. The consequence of this is that attempts to enforce Basel on ships and ship recycling have not succeeded. Because of these problems, parties to the Basel Convention, that is the member states that have ratified Basel Convention, in 2004 came to an agreement to request the International Maritime Organization, IMO, to develop a specific set of regulations to address ships and ship recycling. In 2005, IMO's assembly accepted this request, and work started from 2006 and culminated in 2009 in the adoption of a new international convention. This convention is called the Hong Kong International Convention on the Safe and Environmentally Sound Recycling of Ships. When the Hong Kong Convention comes into force, Basel will not have any involvement with the ship, with the recycling of ships. However, Basel Convention is an important convention in that it deals with the movement, the international movement of waste, and that will continue. One important distinction to make is that whereas Hong Kong Convention covers the requirements on ships and the requirements for recycling facilities, it is not does not have specific requirements for the way any waste that move out of the recycling yard are disposed. However, for the future, I see an important synergy between the two conventions. Whereas Hong Kong Convention has precise requirements for ships and for recycling facilities, that does not extend in any detail for the downstream disposal of waste and the treatment once they leave the yard. On the other hand, the Basel Convention has requirements for its member states to ensure the environmentally sound management of waste or their disposal and treatment. And the synergy I can see is that Hong Kong Convention will regulate the process all the way up to the gate of the recycling facility, whereas the Basel Convention will apply on how any waste that leave the recycling facility gates are treated thereafter. The reasons are that it takes a long time for a government to ratify an international convention. And that happens because, first of all, the convention has to be translated in the language of the country. It needs to go through the administration to check with other laws and regulations to see if there is any conflict. Then it needs to go through parliament at the right time, through cabinet. Stakeholders have to be consulted, and all this process is very lengthy. It's not unusual for international conventions to take 5 years, even from the first countries who ratify them. In the case of the Hong Kong Convention, we have one added complication, and that is that the subject of the convention, ship recycling, affects a number of ministries. There is Ministry of Environment, there is Ministry of Labor, there is Transport and Shipping, and then you may have Commerce, and depending on the country, other ministries. So it is not surprising that it takes time. International regulations are very important to shipping because of the global nature of the industry. Occasionally, there is countries who choose to regulate a matter that affects ships either unilaterally or even regionally, as is the case with the European Union. That has happened with ship recycling. The European Union decided 2 years ago that it might take a long time for Hong Kong Convention to enter into force, and they felt that they needed to address the problem of ship recycling with their own regulation in the meantime. The European Union therefore developed a new regulation which is in the image of Hong Kong Convention, and that regulation is ready to enter into force at the end of this year or beginning of next year. While Europe was developing its own regulation, the European Commission stopped member states from ratifying Hong Kong Convention because the Commission felt that the European regulation would have to come into force before any member states move in ratifying the Hong Kong Convention. There is now a decision that is being prepared of the European Council that will authorize European member states to ratify Hong Kong Convention. So we should expect at least one or two European countries to ratify Hong Kong Convention after the new year. Regional regulations sometimes cause problems to the implementation of an international standard, especially when there is conflict in the requirements of the regional regulation to what has been agreed on the international front. In the case of ship recycling and in the case of the European regulation, I feel that maybe there's not going to be a problem because it looks like the European regulation is in full harmony with the requirements of Hong Kong Convention. If that is the case, the effect of the European regulation would be even to accelerate entry into force of the Hong Kong Convention, maybe by 2 to 3 years. When the Hong Kong Convention enters into force, it will become international law because it is a convention of a United Nations specialized agency. One interesting thing about ship recycling is that for the last 15 years or more, the same five countries have been recycling something like 97% to 98% of the world's tonnage. And these are Bangladesh, India, China, Pakistan and Turkey. If these five countries could be convinced to ratify the Hong Kong Convention, then there will be nowhere else for ships to go. And very interesting thing is that Hong Kong Convention, from an international standard, it will really become a global standard because it will apply to all ships that need to be recycled. To understand how ships are recycled, we have to note first of all that 70% of all tonnage is recycled in South Asia, that is Bangladesh, India and Pakistan, where ships are driven onto a tidal beach and then they are cut when the water recedes. Also, few ships are recycled in Turkey, again using a beach, but that beach is not tidal. The other big part of ship recycling takes place in China, where ships are brought alongside to a pier in a river and they're recycled from cranes that are located usually on the shore. It's very important to understand that dry docks are not used for ship recycling except on very rare cases, simply because of the very high capital costs of having building and operating a dry dock. It is generally assumed that beaching is a polluting and unsafe method, and examples have often been shown of problems with pollution and accidents that have taken place on ships that have been beached. In fact, environmental activists are fighting and have been fighting for some time for the banning of beaching. This, however, is not the way that we can make progress. Banning beaching is too simplistic and it would be a mistake, and let me explain. First is a political dimension, and the political dimension is that the three South Asian countries that recycle 70% of the world's tonnage would never voluntarily accept the banning of beaching, which would close down their industries. Furthermore, the entry into force requirements of the Hong Kong Convention cannot be satisfied without some of the capacity of South Asia, and therefore Hong Kong Convention cannot enter into force without them. Lastly, and perhaps most importantly, Hong Kong Convention was developed with these particular countries in mind so that their industry could be helped to become safer and more friendly to the environment. From the technical perspective, beaching does not have to be polluting. If removal of hazardous waste and polluting waste is done in a systematic way that follows correct procedures, then independent experts confirm that beaching can be conducted in a clean and safe way. For this reason, the Hong Kong Convention does not ban beaching, but instead aims to become the global standard for regulating ship recycling, regardless of the method being used.